What's up athletes, welcome to this video. In this video, we are gonna test and review the Nike Epic React. I'm gonna give you some information about the shoe and give you my personal opinion on the shoe, how I like them, what I like not about the shoe. Now, as you might notice, I wore this shoe many times in many different videos. I think on this channel I haven't worn them, but on Instagram, if you saw my running clips or something like that, you have may notice that I wore these shoes at the time, like months back. Now I have the Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 37, which I'm wearing now. These were my old shoes, or are now my old shoes. I have ran many miles in these shoes, and I now want to give you some feedback and review about this shoe. Before we start with the video, first question: what running shoes are you using? Write it down in the comment section. And now let's start with the video. Let's come to some details about the shoe. Now, the Nike Epic React has a Flyknit upper, which means the material on the upper is very breathable, and it has React foam, which is more of a softer foam, and for training or something like that, it's very good. First, let's come to the comfort and fit. In my personal opinion, this shoe is more of a wider shoe, which for my foot type is good. It is more of a softer shoe, which is because of the Flyknit material or the upper. This makes the shoe very comfortable. And because of this Flyknit material, the shoe is breathable and supports your foot with fresh air. Let's come to the quality and durability. Now, I've ran in these shoes many miles. I wore them for like other sports exercises and wore them like 2 years straight. I mean, these are 2 years old shoes. And considering that, it seems like they have no issues around the upper areas, for example, like here or here, where your toes eventually push on the mesh. But the quality looks very good. I don't have any issues with the shoe. The build quality is perfect. The foam quality is also good. As I mentioned in the last video, I spoke about my running technique and it evolved over time. With these shoes, they made the process. So firstly, I was heel striking and all that, and that you can see on the foam itself has some issues right here. And then I changed my running technique, or I'm in the process of changing my technique. And as you can see, the foam on the forefoot gets kind of destroyed. But overall, as I mentioned before, I wore the shoe like for 2 years straight, did other sports exercises with them, not only running, but like in the gym or in sports class. Then it turned into my running shoe. Considering that I've run so many miles in them, the foam and the upper are super good, and for me the build quality is just insane. Now, what I don't like about the shoe is that they are very slippery because they don't have any rubber on the sole. Like for example, the Pegasus 37 has some rubber, which gives you extra grip on the road or if you run trail. I mean, the shoe is very comfortable on the road and on the trail, but if it rains and the track is very muddy, then with these shoes it is very slippery to run, which is very dangerous at some point. Speaking of the foam and the sole, I think the foam is very good. As I mentioned, the Nike Epic React has React foam, which is very soft, but for longer runs it feels for me too soft, because then because of the soft feeling, I can maybe show you this, but because it is so soft, you can feel the road, and especially for longer runs, it is not as comfortable as for like shorter 10Ks or something like that. I mean, React foam is a more softer foam, and for runs like 5Ks or 10Ks, I mean, the shoe is very light, and for that kind of speed trainings or something like that, I would use the shoe. Now let's come to the result. I would give the Nike Epic React 7.5 out of 10 points for a training shoe. I mean, I'm very happy with this shoe. I've ran like 2 years straight with this shoe. Now, I've bought this shoe for like $50, which is a bit cheaper than it usually costs. This is why I gave the shoe 7.5 out of 10 points, because I think for like $100, I would buy a different kind of shoe. But if you want to have a very durable and good built shoe, then I would recommend the Nike Epic React for training or something like that. I did some races in this shoe. This shoe feels fast, but like the shoe cost a bit too much for me. I would buy a different type of shoe for that price. But if you can have a discount or something like that, then you don't make anything wrong with this shoe. That was it with the video, with the review of the Nike Epic React. If you liked the video and want to see more running content, feel free to like and subscribe to the channel. And then I would say, I see you in the next video. Bye.